Hey there, welcome to Watch Recap. And today, I will recap an action, adventure movie called, Chaos Walking. Okay, so let's start. There exists a planet far away from the Earth, the New World. The sun never sets on this planet. It's year 2258 AD. Some humans left Earth searching for a better place to live, and comes to this planet. All resources they need to settle are here, and even more than that. When humans came to this planet, they found that all men are affected with a condition called the noise. This condition causes them to see and hear what a man is thinking about. Also, a disadvantage is you have no privacy with your thoughts. Though it can be fun when you create 3D holograms with your thoughts, which others can see. There is a civil war going on between the human colonists and a native human species, Spackle. In the war, the Spackles killed every women colonists and half of the men also. As a result, the first group of human colonists lost connection with Earth and the outside world. Todd Hewitt is a young man who lives in the human colony named Prentistown. He lost his parents in the war and now lives with his adoptive fathers Ben Moore and Killian Boyd. As the Spackles killed every woman, Todd has never seen a woman. He spends his day helping his fathers with the field. But he wants to be a man like the colony mayor, David Prentice. Prentice is very good at controlling his noise condition so no one can see or hear his thoughts. Other important men of the colony are Prentice's son Davy and preacher Aaron. Inspired by Prentice, they both compete to be like him and always fight each other. One day, the second group of human colonists arrives in a scout ship. Three crew members are here to investigate the planet and connect with the first human colonists group. But then, while entering the atmosphere of the planet, the scout ship catches fire and crashes nearby Prentistown. While working, Todd sees someone stealing food from their shelter, so he chases the thief into the forest with his dog named Manchi. He loses the thief but instead finds the crashed ship. He realizes the thief must be the survivor from the ship. He rushes to the mayor to inform about this. But on his way, his thoughts are seen and heard by men of the colony, and so they joins him on his way to the mayor to see what happened. Todd tells Prentice that the survivor didn't show any noise thoughts. Prentice concludes then it must be a girl and orders to search for her. While Todd was alone, the girl comes in front of him. He is shocked, scared, but excited to see a girl for the first time. But his thoughts are heard by the men, which alerts them. The girl tries to escape, but Prentice creates a hologram cage around her with his thoughts and catches her. He takes her to his home and says he feels sad for her crew members who died in the crash. He tells her about the noise and the war which killed every woman and half of the men. She tells him about her mission to investigate the planet and find the first human colonist group. She also tells him about the mothership which sent her here. It's the largest ship which holds 4,000 people and they will soon come to rescue her. Prentice's intentions alert the girl as he asks more about the mothership, but he has to go out to calm down the men, as they all are curious to see the girl. Davy is asked to watch the girl, but he instead starts to mess with the girl's bag and belongings. He messes with one of the gadgets which creates a big spark, and it gives her a chance to escape. While escaping, she overhears Prentice talking with Preacher about his plan to take over the mothership and gain control over the planet. He says they have to find her before she informs the mothership about their plan. But Preacher thinks the girl is an angel, sent to punish the men of Prentistown for their sins. As they all leave to search for the girl, Todd steals the girl's bag, hoping to find something awesome to play with. Inside his shelter, he opens the bag to find something, but instead finds the girl herself hiding in a corner. One of the Prentice's men comes looking for her, but Todd helps her hide and asks the man to go away. Ben and Killian finds about the girl and locks her inside. They are scared and wants Todd to hand the girl back to Prentice. But our boy has fallen in love with the girl and wants to help her. Ben and Killian thinks this might let Todd to start his own family, and so allows him to help her. Ben suggests Todd to take the girl to another human town, Farbranch, which Todd didn't know existed. Killian is worried as the men of Farbranch doesn't like men of Prentistown, but Ben says they won't harm him as long as the girl is with him. But before Todd could leave with the girl, Prentice arrives with his men looking for her, so she escapes on a bike and is followed by Todd on his horse. Out of anger, Prentice kills Killian and threatens Ben to help them find the girl and Todd. Todd catches up to the girl, but both of them loses the bike and the horse and now have to walk. They are joined by Todd's dog. On their journey, Todd seems to learn what actually a girl is. He is fascinated by her strength and struggles to keep up with her speed. She doesn't trust him at first, but he wins her trust slowly and even hunts a snake for her to eat. She finally tells him her name is Viola and was born on the mothership. Her parents died during the 64 years of travel from Earth to the New World. Her grandparents were the ones who signed for the journey. Later, Todd is attacked by a spackle. Todd defeats the spackle and is going to kill him, but is stopped by Viola, who asks him to show kindness and mercy. They arrive at Far Branch and realizes that men, women, and children lives here. The town's mayor Hildy welcomes them. Unaware that they hate Prentistown's men, Viola reveals Todd is from Prentistown. He is held in handcuffs while the ladies have a talk in private. The men are thinking of beating Todd, but after talking with Viola, they are stopped by the mayor. Prentice and his men are continuously searching for Todd and Viola. Preacher is very upset and often argues with Prentice. Hildy gives Todd and Viola shelter and food, and also says she can contact her mothership from Haven, which is the first human settlement in New World, which is also unknown to Todd. Viola decides to go next morning. Seeing her so desperate to leave, Todd thinks of her staying with him and kissing him. And yes, she heard his thoughts, so Todd apologizes for this. Hildy gives them separate room to rest, but Todd couldn't sleep thinking Viola leaving soon. He finds his mother's journal, which Ben put in his bag. He shows it to Viola, who is also awake. She asks what is written in it, but poor Todd doesn't know how to read. Prentice burned the books when he wanted to read because he thought having noise is only thing you need in New World. So Viola read it for Todd. His mother's name is Carissa. She reads, "My dear Todd, I started this journal when you were born. You are the most beautiful thing in the world and I wish your papa was here to see you, but God took him. You will be tall, strong, and handsome like your papa. The girls of the New World will fall for you." The man Prentice convinced us to settle on the far side of the swamp so we stay away from the noise of the world. Prentice seems so suspicious to me. He's better at hiding his noise than others. This place is so loud. Men doesn't like women knowing what they're thinking, while they can't see what we are thinking. Almost every man here is going crazy as Prentice and Preacher are feeding them lies. They locked every woman inside. Preacher says women have no noise because they don't have a soul. I could see what they were planning. If things go wrong, keep searching for hope. Todd is breaking down, realizing that the spackles didn't kill the women, but the men of Prentistown did. He feels angry and betrayed as everything he has been told was a lie. But then, Prentice and his men arrives at Far Branch and demands for Viola and Todd. Hildy distracts them so Todd and Viola can escape, but Preacher sees them and so they quickly goes inside a storeroom, where a Far Branch woman helps them by pointing gun at Preacher. Prentice sends Ben to convince Todd for giving away Viola in exchange for his life. But Todd asks him about the journal. Ben says he tried to help the women but was helpless as it was like a war. The best he could do was to keep Todd safe. He apologizes for lying to him and says, "Let me protect you now." Prentice demands them to give him Viola. Ben comes out with Viola. Prentice says he is pleased to see her again. But then, Viola starts to fade, because it was a hologram created by Ben. Real Viola and Todd have escaped with the dog but are chased by Preacher. They get on a boat and tries to escape, but Preacher flips the boat. Todd manages to save Viola and comes out, but Preacher killed Manchi. Todd is filled with rage and is breaking down, but Viola stays by his side and they continue on their journey to Haven. The towers built by the first group helps them to stay on the path. They come across the destroyed colony of the first group. Prentice and his men are getting closer to them. Todd says they should keep moving, but Viola says they don't have time. Scanning the area, she finds the emergency transmitter from the destroyed colony. But the antenna is not working. Viola loses hope. But Todd thinks he can repair it. He climbs up and asks Viola to stay down and tell him when it starts working. He manages to fix the antenna, but Prentice arrives with his men. He threatens Todd that he will kill Ben if he doesn't surrender. But Ben tells his son not to bow in front of him. Meanwhile, Preacher goes inside and attacks Viola. Preacher deeply regrets killing the women of the town as he thought his noise was God and listened to it. He begs Viola to kill him. Left with no choice, Viola ignites him with her gadget. As he's burning, he says, "I am baptized by fire, I am the sinner," and passes away. Viola then sends SOS signal to Mothership, while Todd surrenders himself to Prentice. Prentice asks Todd about the girl so Todd will think about her and he will see where she is, but surprisingly, Todd controls his noise this time. Out of anger, he shoots Ben. Todd rushes to Ben. Ben again apologizes for lying to him about his past, and hands him a knife before passing away. Todd attacks Prentice with the knife but is kicked down the slope, and loses the knife. He rushes to get cover as he's injured. He then attacks Prentice from behind, but it was just a hologram. Now Prentice is about to shoot him, but a hologram appears out of Todd's thoughts. These are the women who were killed by Prentice. They pushes him on the edge and then Viola attacks him with a pipe. He catches the pipe but loses his balance. Viola loses his grip and so the villain of this movie dies. As Viola holds on to injured Todd, the mothership arrives, causing remaining Prentice-town men to run away. Todd then wakes up in mothership's medical room. He is fully healed, having Viola by his side. She says she wants to live in the new world with him, and takes him to meet other colonists. This is where the movie ends. Subscribe to the channel if you love movies, like and share the video, we appreciate it. See you again.